on her notorious episode of Cribs. Check it out.
It's Diva Deja Vu on this special bonus edition of Cribs. We're taking a second look at the legendary lair of Miss Mariah Carey with exclusive never-before-seen footage.
Hurry up, Lair, the clock is ticking.
And special star-studded celebrity commentary.
Now you work, girl. You better work, bitch.
We'll hear from hip-hop heads.
It's like a hotel in there.
Rock queens.
Mariah loves to show off those boobs.
Oh, my God.
And everyone else in between, plus Mariah herself.
I didn't really take a bath. Like, hello. I had on a bodysuit.
And what made this crib unforgettable. So drop that remote, because this is not a rerun. We're blowing it out big with new and exclusive footage and superstar commentary on this Mariah Carey edition of Cribs.
I'm Mariah Carey. Welcome to my crib. Come on in. Of the show. I like Red Man's episode. I'd say that was like number one in my book. When I saw how he was being, I was like, okay, I can do whatever I want. I wasn't trying to be too serious. Like, here's my fabulous abode. I was just like, this is my apartment. Here it is.
Okay, this is my first apartment ever.
I think people like to see things about the artist that they wouldn't normally get to see.
My house is pretty fancy for an apartment.
It's an Art Deco apartment.
You know, her place is all beautified.
The walls are a process called glazing.
That's like a $6-7 million place.
And I like that because they look like candy.
Mariah's decor is very over the top, very lush.
That living room is ridiculous.
Like a hotel in it.
I chose to do the colors neutral so they're not jarring, because I have enough jarring things that happen to me on a daily basis. We don't need that at home.
Right, I got your back, babe.
This is the relaxing, more serious part of the house that most of my friends and I, we don't even bother coming into this area.
I don't go in there, I walk around. I don't want to break nothing because I ain't paying for shit.
I have Marilyn Monroe's piano, and I'm very protective over it.
She paid like $600,000 for that piano.
I would show it to you guys, but I can't.
I think she got a sign on the piano that says, please do not touch.
That's me right there.
Me and Stevie Wonder.
Oh, no, that's Stevie Wonder.
Oh, look, here's the apartment in Architectural Digest.
Who else would show you around their living room with their boobies hanging out? She just cracks me up.
I didn't grow up in a house that belonged in Architectural Digest, trust me. Out here, you can see the Empire State Building.
The view is beautiful.
When I was little, I always wanted a penthouse apartment in New York with a view like this.
The view that I was looking at was where her mic pack was resting between the crack of her ass.
It took me quite a while because all the co-op boards kept telling me no.
If I was part of a co-op, I would let her come in like immediately and welcome her to the neighborhood.
But now it doesn't matter because I have my own.
Mm-hmm.
So now what I think we're gonna do is go into the ladies' lounge, but first we're gonna go into my lingerie closet, okay?
Oh, this is like the lingerie closet. I forgot it's like 15 closets.
I never think that women wear that much lingerie.
See, when I'm at home, I really don't wear clothes. I just wear boxers or things of this nature.
The fact that Mariah has a whole closet devoted to lingerie basically to me says that she celebrates the fact that she's got a hot ass.
All right, now I have to change before we go into the bathroom because it's a very, very serene place for me. So let me go and I will meet you when I'm done.
Everything she does is slightly porno, don't you think?
Try this on. So now we're gonna go to my favorite room in the house.
Uh-oh, she done changed clothes. She done went to the lingerie closet and came back in some lingerie. You work, girl, you better work, bitch. Yeah, that's a big ass shower.
I usually be in the bathtub, but this shower is very nice.
Hang over your head. I don't know if I like that, because if you got a fresh hairdo, you gotta wear plastic cap. The bathroom is ridiculous.
The chandelier is one of my favorite things in this room. That's why we did the recessed lighting in the ceiling.
It's a room in itself. I mean, I could just get me a mattress and sleep on the floor and be straight.
Perhaps a friend might want to sit down, linger on this particular lounge chair. You never know.
I love the candles and the flowers and all the pillows. She's very feminine.
That's just a hopeful dream.
Party people, she getting in the tub.
I think the tub scene might have thrown a bunch of people off.
When I come in here, it's just like I relax.
If I do Cribs, I'm gonna remake that scene. I'm gonna have a little towel, I'm gonna put my foot in the water and do this.
Tell the world, leave me alone, kick everybody out, and proceed to bathe. I didn't really take a bath. Like, hello. I had on a bodysuit. What do people actually think? Like, I'm really gonna be just like stripping and taking a bath? I guess they do think so, because clearly that's gotten me in trouble before. Whatever. Okay, so now I'm gonna take you to the one guest room that I have. Because if you have too many guest rooms, then fools like to stay over a bit too much. So I guess we could call this the butterfly guest room. I like the butterflies.
This is my room right here, ladies and gentlemen. That's where I sleep, right there where the teddy bear is.
I'm not gonna show you guys my bedroom because I think it's better if I keep like one thing for myself.
I just don't give access to my bedroom very often, if ever. So why should it be on national television?
I feel like if I show my bedroom, then what's left for me, you know? But this is a cute bedroom.
There's butterflies everywhere, from the headboard, to the carpet, to the curtain, to the wall, to the chair, from the windows, to the wall.
She gets butterflies when she sees me.
Maybe I'll stay in here tonight. One thing about this guest room that I like is I have books from my fans here.
I keep everything. I get to the point where it annoys the people that have to pack my bags because they're packing all these fan books and all these stuffed animals and all these things and pictures and stuff, because I do put them in the butterfly fan room, which is now a lot more full with stuff, and it's different than it was when we did the show.
These helped me out in a time when I wasn't feeling quite so very happy.
It is nice to dedicate a room to your fans. You might want to go in there and remember that all these people care about you.
The originality of my fans is unparalleled. They make me happy. So we dedicate the butterfly room to them. They can come sleep over here. Now, can I have the thing again? Oh, I'm getting this. I'm like, don't I have three people upstairs working for me? We don't have to clean it all now.
In Mexico, Tanya.
I'm gonna lead you to another room as we change and walk simultaneously. Hurry up, Blair, the clock is ticking.
I know.
Okay. Woo! Here we are in an unfinished room. These are some little moments. This is me on tour. What else do we have? An award I won from Playboy. Okay, so now we're gonna go into my favorite room. Notice how all these rooms are my favorite. I get a lot of work done in here. It's the laundry room.
What?
That part I don't believe.
Not many people like to admit that they do the laundry. I also scrub the floors, do all the cooking myself. I'm quite a homemaker.
She can cook, but I've never seen her do her own laundry.
I also have a love of animals.
Oh, Lord, she's put the dog in the dryer.
Oops, I locked my keys in the car. Oops, I let my terrier in the dryer.
I was just being stupid and having a good time.
Every dog can have a hairdo like this.
That dog gets her hair done, her nails done, her toes. She probably get colonics.
My friends got the humor, and a lot of people who don't know me that have a sense of humor were like, oh, she was so funny on that show, I really liked it. And then some people were just like looking for something to say, so they were just being stodgy.
You look very good, Ginger, give me a kiss. Give me kisses.
Now we're gonna go to, truthfully, my favorite room in the house, the kitchen. That's really the dog's bed in here. Go in, Ginger, that's good.
Ginger is so spoiled.
She treats her dogs like they're royalty, they're her babies.
I want it to be like a country kitchen in the middle of the city.
That's really cool. Little House on the Prairie style.
This I selected, it's called Butterfly, and I liked it because it actually looks like it's butterfly wings. This bell is from the Tower of Terror amusement ride. And the reason it's in this kitchen is just because a lot of stupid remarks get made. All any of us has to do is hit the bell and keep it moving.
Rat don't never get shut down. And Mariah wouldn't do that to me because we best friends.
That's cool right there, couch in the kitchen, because people always want to be in the kitchen.
This is where I usually sit in this kitchen. I even eat in this spot. I have a rule against sitting up straight.
She's such a diva, man.
I prefer to lounge, so I put this chair here.
You want to lay down and keep eating. That's all right.
And this, I want it to be cozy for friends and people to congregate at the table. I have little pictures of everyday life.
I'm sure I'm on that wall.
There's Brat Tat Tat.
We all been on so many trips together.
Me with the rainbow. There's me and Riri, this girl right here. Swimming with dolphins. Cause I am someone who loves dolphins. Okay, this is Willie and this is Jack. And the event of this kitchen is usually the two of them playing.
Jack is just like a terror. If you at her house, you gotta be Jack's friend or you gotta leave.
Wow! Oh no, Jack is biting the cat's ass.
It kept the part where my dog attacks the cat. And I felt so bad for my cat because it was abusive and they kept it in there.
I think her dog was trying to have sex with the cat. I always do that too.
This is my life, guys. At home, in the country kitchen, in the middle of downtown New York City. So now I'm gonna show you the other floor.
It's like 12 levels in this place. It's ridiculous.
This is like for the people that don't necessarily need, I mean, they're my friends and everything, but they don't have to come to the 17th floor with Marilyn's piano and things that I'm quite frightened of getting broken. So basically, we all come down here for the relaxation area. Since I'm a vagabond, I didn't have a place to live. Been traveling, you know, living in hotels. My awards were in storage, and so now I'm happy we got these antique award cases.
When you finally find that place that you want to put your awards up, that's when you really feel like you got a house.
These are American Music Awards. I'm very proud of them because they represent the people.
Damn, she got a lot of them.
The first American Music Award I won is Favorite Female Soul, Rhythm, and Blues Artist. This is the Artist of the Millennium one that I won, and I was so excited and proud of it.
Her voice is a gift from God. She deserves them all.
It's kind of how I chronicle my life.
Now we're going to the movie room. The aqua blue walls, the couch looks like sand.
This would be the room where I like to call it the mermaid room, but the mermaids aren't painted on the walls yet.
It's just so diva-ish that she would give her entertainment room a name and a theme. It's very Mariah. She's very camp.
Right now we're watching The Little Mermaid. See, people call me a mermaid because I like to swim.
It's beautiful. It's like an aquarium.
I got this fish tank and this saltwater fish, but they're hiding right now. I had to get them changed to be nocturnal because they were on the opposite schedule as me.
Smart. Good work, Mariah. Make the fish sleep when you're sleeping. When you're up, you're up.
It's nice to come down here
and see the fishies.
It's your world, baby.
Theme for the room, it's like a pale blue under the sea type thing.
It makes you feel like you're on a beach in Miami or something.
This room is really supposed to be seen only at night, because if you see it during the day, you kind of like think I might have been on something when I decided to do it in this color scheme. I have been told that these sofas are like the most comfortable sofas in all the land.
You can tell that her couches are very comfortable. Me, they would have been black.
You just lie down here and people randomly fall asleep.
Is these people that had sex with her or didn't have sex with her? Huh?
How did you get here? Who does the best imitation of me upon falling asleep on this thing and then not wanting to be woken up?
That couch right there is so comfortable. I'm telling you, all you need is like a sheet or a blanket and you out.
I have a problem sleeping, so when I finally sleep, you know, it's a monumental occasion.
Forget about the movie. It's over.
Baby girl, it's time to get up.
I'm just like, it's all because of this sofa.
Exactly.
Good night.
There was a popcorn all over the place. That's what I'm talking about.
This area right here, this is just the kitchen for down here.
I think it's hot to have a kitchen in your movie room.
We don't have to run all the way upstairs and get stuff. We could have like pizza or whatever. Or everybody else can have pizza and I can have two bites of something.
I think that's brilliant.
Keeps everything contained in the mermaid room.
I'ma steal that.
So now I'm gonna take you to a place that is not fully finished. My little vocal booth. Very small, but silent. Got some butterflies on the ground. It takes a while to build these places, so soon I'll be singing in here.
Now I think Mariah is the only celebrity with her own mermaid room, but hey, she's earned it, right? Now there's more of her one-of-a-kind commentary coming your way only on MTV's Bonus Features Blowout. We've also convinced Exhibit to show us what goes down when someone is about to get pimped. So, hope you guys enjoy. Here's what happens when contestants attack on Pimp My Ride.
Oh, by the way, look at this bathroom. We're not done with it yet, but look how cute. They painted this all. Butterfly here. You can see like a pale blue ceiling up there. It's very subtle. But I quite like it. Okay, so now I'm gonna take you into the place where I spend most time while I'm here. The full-blown salon!
To have a full-service salon in your home when you're somebody like Mariah is really a necessity.
I'm surprised more celebrities don't have that.
When they're not working on me, they tend to like work on each other.
She don't play about her hair, she don't play about her makeup or her clothes.
I can do hair too, because I have 500 hours beauty school.
I don't know what she gonna do with them 500 hours, because she ain't gonna never do nobody else's hair.
I think those are hours of her sitting in someone else's chair, that's what she mean.
How many hours in hair beauty school did you have?
1,200.
1,200. See, I only had 500. You know why? Because I quit. I wasn't good enough at the pin curls and the roller.
You could sing much better than you could do hair.
Right. You shouldn't quit. Everybody out there, keep going. Hang on. Now I'm gonna take you to the extended version of my closet.
People focused on my closet a lot.
This is my closet.
Oh God, it's amazing. I want that closet.
As you can see, it's not really a traditional closet, but I worked hard for this mess.
You look like something in Fred Siegel.
Little gold leaf designs on the floor. That's a little M behind you. See that? What takes me the longest is picking out a t-shirt to wear.
As you notice, all the colors are coordinated.
We have like 20 million of the same white tank. My favorite ones are stained.
She needs a lot. Every girl does.
But it's okay. We'll get new ones.
My fans often give me Hello Kitty stuff. I live for it.
It's cute, right?
She loves Hello Kitty. Oh my God.
I have a Hello Kitty bathroom. The whole thing is like overflowing. It's like a five-year-old's fantasy room.
I think what I should do, take the hair down and find an ensemble that's going to make me feel a little more festive.
Oh, what's she gonna show us now?
Is that festive or the red one? The red one kind of makes me look fat though.
Each dress is probably more than $10,000.
That's every girl's dream.
This is the dress that I wore on the RFK show. Completely and totally empty in the back, but I find it quite demure in the front.
Mariah loves to show off those boobs. If I had those boobs, I'd be there with her.
You might recognize these from Heartbreaker.
There's her infamous jeans.
And the top cut off, which is like very 2 years ago now.
She started the jeans cut off at the top.
Then we have always a vintage Sergio. I just can't let him go. Can't let him go. All right, let me throw on my other ensemble and then we'll be back.
You couldn't expect to see Mariah walk around the house for about 2 hours in the same clothes.
What are we thinking, yes?
You you think your dress could be any lower, Mariah?
Yeah. I don't like this.
The black sequin dress, it reminds me of something Tina Turner would have worn.
One more second.
I like the way she kept changing. I think that's fabulous to be able to change whenever you want.
All right, I'll keep this on now for the moment, just to keep the momentum going.
Why not? She's earned it.
Look at that shoe room. That look crazy. It's probably 2,000 shoes in that room.
This is the shoe room.
Oh, my God. Jimmy Choo, Versace, Gucci, Hoochie, Tucci, Bertolucci, anybody you can name, she got.
The style that I favor would be a high stiletto. And the brand that I favor would be whoever's gonna stick to that motif.
I don't see how she wear like 9-inch heels and stilettos and all that. A bitch like me would fall on my face.
Thing about my shoes are, they always hurt. But hey, if they look good, Blair's kind enough to help me put them on.
If I had her money, I'd have some putting off my shoes as well and wiping my ass.
There was a time in my life when I only had one pair of shoes. I saved those shoes, but I can't find them now. They were like all destroyed and the snow used to come through them. These are my new patriotic shoe. I haven't worn them yet, but they're very patriotic.
I bet those cost about $5,000.
Diego Dolcini sparklers.
Honey, that ain't Swarovski, that's some real Some of them shoes are real diamonds on those shoes.
Oh yeah, the Loverboy boots are over here.
Great for a video, but wouldn't wear them out.
People gave me some comments about these. Matter of fact, I might have to change this whole ensemble just to wear these boots. These would be my Pamela shoes.
Stripperella, baby.
I personally can't walk in them. Those are the basics of my shoe room. The girl who had one shoe now has many. Okay, so I decided to leave this ensemble on for the next place that we're going to hit, which would be the gym that rarely gets used.
Most divas do have gyms in their apartment, but I'm an old diva, so it doesn't count.
I do like to beat this guy up, but I can't get my gloves on right now because I don't have anyone to help me do it.
She beats that thing up because she be pretending it's somebody else. I ain't gonna tell y'all who.
So I can stand here, look at New York, things of that nature, all the while in my 4-inch heels and the black ensemble.
I'm joking around, people. Hello. I don't really ride the Stairmaster in my high heels, but I would.
So now we have the top floor of the apartment. And basically there's a bar up here, has its own little bathroom, and this is where folks can come and hang out as well.
This room right here to me is the dopest room in the house.
This is the Moroccan room. It's very festive. It's very like a mirage took place here.
The room has got the view, the ceiling, the couch.
It's like a fairy tale room, so that's why I like it. It's especially nice when you're looking out at this view of Manhattan. That's what I've always wanted.
I love to go outside those doors and look at New York.
Penthouse view, and yeah, a nice relaxing space.
Some people were like taking everything I did totally seriously. I was just having fun.
She has a great feel for life. I just loved her whole approach to it.
The lady's obviously smart. She wants to have the highest rated crib.
This is the Cribs episode that set off the whole Cribs foundation, if you ask me.
That's what Mariah does. It's show business. That's what we're supposed to do.
I thought it was funny.
Okay, so you've seen most of my house. It's time to go. I love you. Thank you. Bye.
Well, life is truly a fairy tale for Mariah Carey, especially when you get her personal take on Cribs. It's all part of MTV's bonus features blowout.